my name is Steve, and I want first of all to welcome you on our booth. So the booth is the booth of the company SolarLog. SolarLog is a German company, and we are specialized in monitoring and energy management. So SolarLog can monitor your PV plant, can make sure that your PV plant is working normally. And SolarLog can also control your consumption and can switch on and switch off consumer inside the building if you want to optimize the self-consumption. So SolarLog is a monitoring system for your PV plant, and it's also an energy management device. So let's go a little bit more into details. So SolarLog, actually we have sold our devices in 180 countries, and we have sold today more than 279,000 devices. So this means that on our server, on our portal, we are following actually and today 12.5 gigawatts. So when it comes to market, on which type of plant can we install one of our logger? You can install our logger on small residential plant, on commercial plant, or on utility scale plant. I will show you later, we have several types of devices, and depending the size of your plant, you can install a small logger, a medium logger, or a large one. So we have a complete range of products to cover the complete market of PV plants. A short overview of our company and the position of our company in the market. So you see that this is our bubble. So the size of the bubble is showing the number of giga the company is following. So we have one of the biggest one. And we are mainly acting on the residential and commercial and industrial sector. The proof, or another argument, here is a focus on residential market. You see that definitively SolarLog, with another brand, you know this one, is one of the leaders of the market when it comes to monitoring and energy management systems. So what is exactly the SolarLog? SolarLog is this, and SolarLog is this as well. So this is the two devices, or two type of devices we have. So this is a gateway, when this is a data logger. So connect this one to your PV inverter, connect this one to your meter, connect this one to your consumers, and this one will make sure that everything is working perfectly. This one can catch the data, the production data of your inverter, can control the production of your inverter, can decide to switch on and to switch off consumers inside the building to maximize the self-consumption. So this one and this one are really the brain of your PV installation inside the building. One of the main jobs of these two devices is not only to take care of the data, it's also to send this data to internet. So these two devices will send data to our portal, and on this portal you can easily track all your plants, and you can easily remotely check if your plants are working perfectly or not. A short overview of what SolarLog is able to do. So as I have mentioned, we came from the monitoring sector. SolarLog at the beginning in 2007 was acting as a monitoring device. Now we are also able to act as a feeding management device. You have, for example, more and more countries in the world where you can put PV on your roof, but it's forbidden to push any energy back to the grid. It's what you are calling the 0% regulation. Put PV, use PV, but it's forbidden to push energy back to the grid. So the logger is able to do it, and we can do what you are calling the 0% regulation. As I've told you a little bit before, the SolarLog is also able to switch on and off consumers inside the building. We can decide by using the surplus calculation if you have enough space to switch on and off several devices to maximize the self-consumption rate. And the last service, SolarLog is also able to monitor your plant and to give you a call or a mail when something is going wrong on your installation. To do such type of things, we need to understand the device you are working with. So we need to be compatible with the device you have installed. So if you have installed one of these logger, or if you have installed one of these solutions, we are able to control, to discuss and to talk with your inverter, or to discuss and to talk with your battery system, or with your load. So the first thing to make sure is that you are using one of these solutions to be compatible with our device. When it comes to the load management or to the energy management system. I like this view because this is really the reflect of what SolarLog wants to do. SolarLog wants to start from something complicated and wants to do something easy. Smart energy load management can be really complex, and we are trying our best to do easy thing. Here you can easily identify from where the energy is going, is coming, and where the energy is going. It's an easy cockpit view, an easy energy flow view, where your customer can, in one shot, easily detect or see what he's doing. Why is this market important for us? Because, as I've mentioned, we are selling our devices in more than 110 countries all over the world. And in more and more countries, the feeding tariff is going down when the price of energy is going up. So we have more and more people who want to use their own energy instead of selling this energy to the grid. We have more and more countries where it's forbidden to send energy back to the grid. So here we have also a good opportunity with our system. We have more and more countries without feeding tariff at all. Like, for example, in France, I'm taking care of France. In France, you are going to stop with feeding tariff. So we have a good opportunity with smart energy and load management. How to do it? It's quite easy. Just take the SolarLog, connect the SolarLog to the consumption meter, connect the SolarLog to your inverter as well, and then the logger will do the calculation, difference between production and consumption, to estimate the surplus. And if the surplus is big enough, we will decide to switch on or off devices inside the building to maximize the self-consumption. So which type of devices can we control? We can actually control two types of device, intelligent and non-intelligent devices. So what is an intelligent device? An intelligent device, it's a system we can control by protocol. For example, a heat pump on one of these heating elements, we can be controlled by protocol. Connect this one directly to this one, and we can talk device to device. So here we can easily switch on, switch off, or send a signal to these devices. If you want to switch on a TV, or if you want to switch on a coffee machine, or anything else like that, then we need to use one of these, a smart plug or a relay. Smart plug for small devices, relay for medium and large devices. So whatever the type of system you want to switch on, you have a solution, protocol-based or mechanical switch on and off. And here you have a nice view, so in reality you have two views. This one is the customer view. You see in yellow the PV production, in green the part of energy of consumption covered by PV, and in red here the part of energy coming from the grid. In red, what I've bought from the grid, in green, what I've used from the PV, and in yellow, what I've pushed back to the grid. Here, the same view, with the same data, but for technician. Here, it's more for end user, when this graphic is more for technician. So here, we have a little bit, you can zoom, you can have more detail on this one than on this one. This one is designed to be used by your customer, when this one is designed to be used by you. We can also support the grid, so we can switch on and off devices, but we can also regulate the production. In more and more countries, like in Germany, for example, we have to play with reactive power, and the system has to switch or has to modify the cost file of the plant. This type of things can be done using the logger. The logger can play with active and reactive power. Last but not least, the charging station, SolarLog is able as well to communicate with charging station. We will send a signal to the charging station to tell the charging station if you have enough energy to start charging the car using the PV energy. So we will send the signal to this one, and this one will still stay the brain of the system, but this one will decide if we can start using PV or not. So for us, this is really important, that this is going to be one of the focus for the two next year, I will say, is to develop and to integrate more and more charging stations. Because for us, it's definitely one of the hottest topics we have. We have more and more people coming to us asking if they can integrate it PV with their car or with the charging station. This is possible. And for example, here we have a nice view. You see the PV production for this day, and this is the part of production we have sent to the charging station to charge the car. This is also important for us because here we can imagine that you have 25 million of cars on one network. Then we can have an issue, a big issue for us regarding the grid stability. So the idea for us is also to help the grid and to stabilize the grid by being able to correctly incorporate the PV production inside the electrical grid. So here you have another view, like, as I've mentioned, we can play with active and reactive, and we can also limit the active consumption or the active production. Here we have an example of what we are doing in Germany. We have the 70% regulation, so it's not allowed. We are not allowed to push more or to produce more than 70% of the plant capacity. Here you see that we are producing and suddenly the plant is reduced. Why? Because we have to follow this regulation. So we can act as a grid management system, as I have told you a little bit before. I think, or I hope I'm good in time. Yeah? So let me know if you have any questions or if you want to know. Okay.
So what's the benefit of your system over the ones provided by the inverter manufacturers?
Let me show you an image. This flexibility. Whatever the type of inverter you are using, whatever the type of battery system you have one solution, one platform with all the data. The choice of your inverter will not depend on your monitoring system. You are able to follow all your choice and all your decision.
Yeah, sorry. Is it possible to put different installation sites with different inverters on your platform?
Yes, of course. You can not only put different inverter on our platform, but you can also connect different inverter brand on our device. We have on one solar log, you can connect up to 5 different brands of inverter. So it's definitely the main advantage is the flexibility. If you have on your plant 2 brands of inverter, you can use one solar log and you connect brand A and brand B on the same device.
Do you have mobile connection at your solar log systems that you can use mobile network, 3G?
The logger is like a small laptop. So we have a RG45 cable after a connection. After this RG45 connection, put what you want. 3G, UMTS, or an external solution, yes. Yes, yes.
Does the data stay on a cloud or a local device? And how much data?
Both. You can ask the system to send data on the web, and then we can store the data for you. And you can also store the data locally. We have a SD card inside the logger with 20 years of data inside the logger locally. And of course, if you are using the web solution, we can also send the data to you. You can have a hard copy of the data even if you are using the web solution. Yes, depending on the size of your plant. For small plants, no. For medium and large plants, yes, we have a small subscription.
You had a question?
Yes, I want to find out roughly what kind of pricing are we looking at for small residential application?
How can I say? Normally, we are not talking about price in such type of events, but if you are talking about a residential plant, we have our solution are starting at 100 euro. Yeah. But I don't want to go too deep in detail when it comes to price.
Okay, I think if there's no more question, I thank you very much, Mr. Puzar. Thank you.